I'm here in Boston, USA, enjoying the fantastic weather, and over there on the horizon you can see the center of Boston, the actual city. The bit behind me here is called Back Bay, Boston, and crossing the Charles River is the Harvard Bridge, and that joins Back Bay, Boston to over there, not Harvard. So even though Harvard University is in that direction, the buildings over there on the opposite shore are MIT. And a lot of people think, well, hang on, why would you have a Harvard Bridge going to MIT? And there are two very good reasons. First of all, the bridge is not named after Harvard University. It's named after Reverend John Harvard. So both the university and the bridge are named after the same person. And secondly, the bridge was put here in 1891, and MIT was only put on that site in 1916. That said, MIT has had a big impact on this bridge, and more importantly, the way it's measured. In fact, the way a lot of things have measured, this bridge gave us a new unit of measurement. Harvard Bridge is 364.4 smoots long, and that is a fact we have known since 1958, when a then undergraduate at MIT called Tom O'Connor, who was a member of the Lambda Chi Alpha fraternity, got sick of having to walk all the way across this bridge in the miserable Boston weather, a sensation I can very much appreciate. And more specifically, he got sick of not knowing how far away he was from the warmth and comfort of the MIT buildings at the other end. And so when he was put in charge of giving tasks to the new pledge people who wanted to become members of his fraternity, he thought, well, I can use them to measure this bridge for me. And he thought, well, why use a standard boring measurement when we could come up with a new one? So he looked at the new pledges and he picked one of them to be the unit. He picked specifically the one of them who was the shortest, because he figured that would make it the most labor-intensive task, which apparently is important for a pledge task. And he picked the one with the funniest sounding, most scientifically unit-like name. And that was a poor individual called Oliver Smoot. And so him and his other fellow members of the fraternity-to-be had to come out here onto the bridge and measure the distance all the way across in smoots. So how far am I across the bridge? Well, I've just passed a suspicious number 90, and not that far up here I can see a 100. And these are the measurements that poor Smoot and his friend put in place. They started off, initially he would lie down on the ground, they'd mark his head, he'd move, they'd mark, and then they put major notches every 10 smoots. But as I said, there are over 400 smoots across, and so by the time they were a good couple hundred in, apparently he was getting quite sick of having to get up every single time. And so it was decided instead they would let him just lie in place. They would mark the beginning and end, and then they would simply drag or pick him up and move him to the next location, measure again, and they continued that over and over and over again. So if that measurement took place in 1958, why are these markings, 150 smoots, still here? Well, initially the members of the Lambda Chi Alpha fraternity would come back and mark them on every single year. Here we go, 160. The police, you think, would be somewhat against members of the university coming out and defacing the public sidewalk at regular intervals as some kind of graffiti tradition. However, it turns out that having these markings is super useful. The police actually used them to record the location of traffic accidents. And when the bridge was completely redeveloped around the late 1980s, it was decided to actually incorporate them into the bridge. I have a quote here from the Massachusetts Metropolitan District Commission, who are in charge of the bridge. They said, "We recognize the Smoot's role in local history. That's not to say that the agency encourages graffiti painting, but smoots aren't just any kind of graffiti. They're smoots. And so when the construction company puts in these concrete blocks, and you can see the dividing lines between them, traditionally these would be 6 foot apart. A smoot, however, is 5'7". That's how tall Oliver Smoot was, and indeed still is. And so on this bridge, and this bridge alone, the divisions between the concrete sections are exactly 1 smoot apart. They're 5'7" between each one. Very sadly, they don't run continuously. There are other breaks in the bridge, and so the markings come in and out of phase. But as of the 1980s, the bridge isn't just measured in smoots, it fundamentally has them incorporated into its structure. Okay, 350 smoots, which means we are almost there at the far side of the bridge, and 360 followed by, here it is, the very end, 364.4 smoots plus or minus, and here, and this is one of my favorite parts of the whole measurement process that they did back in 1958. They didn't return with an exact measurement of 364.4 smoots. It was plus or minus an ear, so another hilarious body part reference. And if you look this up online, a lot of the references to the number of smoots across Harford Bridge just give it as plus an ear, which I think defeats the purpose. The students knew no measurement is ever perfect. There's always some uncertainty, but we can quantify those error bars. And so they deliberately returned it with a plus or minus. And I am sincerely really impressed to see the modern students have put the plus or minus back into the sign. The one thing that is missing is the original plus or minus an ear. The E in ear was a Greek epsilon character, because in science and maths you use epsilon to represent a very small but non-zero value, and so plus or minus epsilon means there's a little bit of error in your measurement, and so they had epsilon as the E in ear. But there you are, to this day the ambiguity in all measurements is represented in this part of the sidewalk. Okay, so over there is where the final measurement was. Behind me is now MIT, but if I cross back over to the other side of the bridge, there is a plaque over here dedicated to Smoot. So here it is, in commemoration of the 50th anniversary of the Smoot. There is a plaque here dedicated to Oliver Reed Smoot, MIT class of 1962. Now, a lot of people are probably wondering, whatever happened to Oliver Smoot? Where is the Smoot these days? And he's still alive and well, and he's had, I wish I was making this up, it sounds too good to be true, he has had a long and distinguished career in standards and measurements. So he at one point was the chairperson of the American National Standards Institute, and for a while he was the president of the International Organization for Standardization, so the ISO, as some of you will know it, and everyone will have benefited from the work of the ISO promoting international standards. If you've ever made a copy of a disk on your computer, you've had a .ISO file. If you've adjusted the exposure on a camera, those are your ISO settings. So he's actually gone on to work in standards and measurements, but I can't tell if that's because, you know, obviously maybe being used as a measurement on this bridge was such an impactful event in his formative years that put him on that trajectory in life. Or maybe Tom O'Connor was onto something. The name Smoot, it sounds like a good solid bit of measurement work. Or what I think might be more accurate, the guy just had a fantastic CV. Is there any better resume fodder going for a standards job than saying that you yourself are a standard? I mean, who of us here wouldn't give the job to that guy? The Smoot has been hidden everywhere. If you go onto Google Calculator, which is just putting a calculation to the Google search bar, I've made it sound more exciting than it is. Go onto Google and search for the speed of light in smoots per second, and it will give it to you. The speed of light is approximately 1.672 times 10 to the 8 smoots per second. And if you go onto Wolfram Alpha and you search for the distance to the sun in smoots, so one astronomical unit in smoots, it will tell you that that is 8.735 times 10 to the 10 smoots. So the distance to the sun is over 87 gigasmoots. So that is the story of the Harvard Bridge and the unit of measurement, the smoot, that it spawned. And I love this story because it harks back to a time when measurements were based on bits of humans. I mean, a smoot is defined as 5 foot 7 inches, and feet that are old units that were based on the average size of a human foot, and an inch can be tracked back to the size of a thumb. So in our modern age, where we don't do that anymore, where meters are defined, well, they were defined as 1/40 millionth of the circumference of the Earth, and now they're based on the speed of light, there's still room to have some fun with old-fashioned and quirky style units. And that is why I love the smoot. And a final moral of the story, standards and measurements, yes, they're something we can have fun with, but our modern society relies on them. We couldn't have an international tech society without standards. And I guess Oliver Smoot embodies both aspects, the fun and the standards. And so that is why I have made this video honoring him. Thank you so much for watching my video about smoots. I got severely rained on to make it. As always, if you can subscribe or like the video, I really appreciate that support. And if you can share the video, even better. If you're one of my Patreon supporters, I'm about to walk back across the bridge in the rain against my better judgment. I'm going to talk a bit about why I'm filming this on a GoPro for a start. It's quite an unusual and unfortunate reason, but what are you going to do? If everyone else who's not a Patreon supporter, don't stress. I appreciate all of the support. As always, watching and sharing the videos is the best thing you can do. Thank you very much.